100%, what happens there? Yep. Is there, it, like, if God only forgives you to the measure you forgive others, what if you've struggled your whole life to forgive someone and you just, it seems like an impossibility. What happens? Will you not be forgiven?
That's what the scripture says. And that's one of the things that we don't preach too much about. Matthew chapter 6 is so clear. I mean, it's just so clear, Chris. It says this: for if you forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive you yours. Is that clear? Or not? So you can struggle all you like, but at the end of the day, that's what Jesus said that the condition for you being forgiven by God is that you forgive others. And if you're not willing, then neither is God willing.
So the whole topic of forgiveness is so, for me, like hearing that now, it's so much bigger than it's ever been preached.
Yeah.
Because eternity,
yeah,
to me, it sounds like eternity lays on the balance on my willingness to be open and forgive.
Totally. And I preach that, and I believe that, and that's the basis of discipleship. And this is the issue, is that a lot of preachers don't preach this. They say, no, it's all by grace. And I say, well, let's rip this page out of the Bible then, because it's there. But there's no buts about it. He's God saying. And then there's a parable that he gives about the two debtors. One was forgiven, you know, billions of dollars. And then he goes out and he finds his friend that only owed him a few hundred dollars and says, pay up until, you know, and the guy says, but I don't have the money, I'll pay. Well, into jail you go. When the king found out about it, it says, what? I forgave you billions and you weren't willing to forgive hundreds? Into jail you go. And the parable is all about out of darkness and weeping and gnashing your teeth. It's very, very confronting. But at the end of the day, Chris, I don't believe that the scripture is vague in this. I believe it's very clear that if we want God to forgive us, then there's a condition, and the condition is we forgive others. Very powerful.
It's powerful. Well, I've never seen that before. I've never seen the condition of that, of forgiveness there. So if there was, if there is someone struggling with unforgiveness towards anyone, and that is holding them back to their full destiny in Christ and ultimately eternity, could you sum it up in one thing? What is the one thing that they need to do right now in order to release the forgiveness in their heart?
Let go. They're the monkey trapped with that jar. And you know, John Bevere calls it the bait of Satan. He puts those baits out there to trap us and stop us from moving in our destiny. We just got to let it go. We just got to stop focusing behind us and start focusing in front of us, because unforgiveness is all about looking behind instead of looking forward. I can't change what's happened to your past. All I can say to you is that God somehow, in his mercy, is going to turn it around. Can you trust him to do that? And if you say yes, then let it go.